antenna bezel was in bad shape, so I wanted to replace it and also put a new short antenna on it. My old antenna wasn't broke off. I cut it short years ago because I didn't like the look of it. Unfortunately, the bezel was so brittle and gummy that I had to break it apart to get it out.
Bit of soap on this edge to help let it slip on better.
There is a haze that forms on the headlight covers, so I use a plastic polish from Meguiar's to clean them up. This isn't too bad this time, so the camera may not pick up the difference when I'm done. The hood latch has some rust on it, and it bugs me every time I see it. So I will paint that black so it fades into the grill better. sometimes my doors stick when we go to open them, so I am spraying some silicone on a rag and wiping the rubber weather stripping to see if that helps. My window moldings are a disaster, and I've been wanting to replace them for a while now. Here are short clips showing two of them getting replaced. There is a link in the description if you want to watch the whole thing.
Alright, I just tore that out of there because I don't need it, so I just tore it out. Broke it out. Everything seems lined up. Good for that. Oh yeah, I got it. There you go. Looks nice. Let's pull it in. There you go. Oh yeah. Sweet. It's all the work going down there. This back one, it's the same way. See the rubber just dry rot it off there.
Look out. Break it off, but I'll try and do it. Sorry, Jeff. So I got a YouTube video.
I'm sure I took the wrong approach, but like I said, they're just throwing them out, so I don't care how they come out.
I didn't want to, just like my original, sometimes for the Toyota revenue. Okay, just slide it into there. Push it on the group there and take it in. Seems to be good. Doesn't touch.
Nice slide.
Well, this didn't go as smooth as I wanted it to. Watch the pros on YouTube to see how it's done the right way. I had to do it outside because I don't have a garage. My spray didn't have enough baby shampoo in it. I did it by myself. I think you get the point. Anyway, I think I can live with it, or I will just tear it off and try it again. I found the AS1 marking on my windshield. I think you are not allowed to put tint below that mark. I measured how much space there was to the top of the window and then stuck a piece of tape on the opposite side so I had a reference to line the tint up against so it is straight across the window.
It's not too bad. Right down to the ASM or AS1 marking. And it's see how dark it is. It's got some see how it works out when the sun dries it out. It's got marks in it, but I don't know. It's not, I don't know if it's gonna bother me or not. When you're driving, you really can't see much of it anyway, but see how it goes.
I was missing some valve stem caps, so I decided to buy some new ones off Amazon and replace them at this time too. Welp, these chores are done now and I finished it up with a vacuuming and wash.